Good morning everybody. Today I am going to discuss here probability. And probability is simply possibility of any event. And for knowing in details probability, we have to know few terms related to probability. And then first one is the experiment and second one is random experiment. Experiment means any action for getting so many possible outcome is called experiment, like throwing a coin, then throwing a die, tossing a coin, drawing out a card from a pack of cards, like that. So this is experiment. And random experiment in general, for all the problems we are going to consider, experiment means simply a random experiment, because random experiments, the meaning of random experiment, you don't know what is going to be the result for your action. This is a random experiment. So mainly all kind of experiment is a random experiment. So suppose you are going to tossing two coins, so you don't know what going to become for head or tail. So this is a random experiment. Without knowing anything, you are going to do any action. So this is random experiment. Without knowing the result, you are doing any action. So this is called random experiment. Tossing a coin, throwing a die, drawing a card, like this. So this is a random experiment. I will explain in details. Wait, just in question also I will explain. Now, the very important word is a sample space. For probability is very important, and we need for all the experiment sample space. And sample space is a collection of all possible outcome. Sample space is a collection of all possible outcome. For throwing a die, we can get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So this is all possible outcome. It can be 1, it can be 2, it can be 3, it can be 4, it can be 5, it can be 6 for throwing a die. So that's why collection of all possible outcome is called sample space. And sample space is denoted by simple capital S. Sample space is denoted by simply capital S. So sample space for throwing a die is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But for tossing a coin, sample space will be head and tail. So for tossing a coin, sample space will be head and tail, and for throwing a die, sample space will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is sample space, just collection of all possible outcome. Now event, what is event? Event is a subset of sample space. For example, here we are going to collect the number, even number. We are going to find out even number for this experiment, we are going to collect for even number. And even numbers are 2, 2, 4, 6. That means even for this experiment, getting a even number will be 2, 4. Probability to get an even number is 2, 4, 6. So you can see here also, this example is given here. So the subset of a sample space associated with random experiment. The subset of a sample space associated with random experiment is called event. I think event is clear for everybody. Now you can go for next. Now occurrence of an event is very simple. Just when the outcome of random experiment satisfied the condition mentioned in the event. For example, suppose for throwing a coin, you want to get head for throwing a coin, and this head only came. So then the event will be occurrence. occurrence of an event, because you are considering that the head will come, but head came. So that's why it is occurrence of an event. Now favorable outcome. So according to the question, that means probability to get even number, probability to get more than 5, probability to get prime number. So like this kind of all outcome will call favorable outcome. So you can see for this question, getting a prime number for throwing a dice 2, 3 and 5. So these 2, 3, 5 are possible. Possible favorable outcome according to this question, getting a prime number. Now one more, that is equally likely outcome, that means when the number of events are present equally. Suppose for tossing a coin, you can get only head and one time only tail. But in a container there is so many red ball and only white ball is one, so many red ball are there. But see here, number of red ball 5, but number of white ball is 1. So this is not equally likely outcome, but this is equally likely outcome, because head also 1, tail also 1 time present. For a die also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This all number present individually, single time. So this is equally likely outcome. But this one is not equally likely outcome. But if there will be 5 white ball, so white ball, 5 white ball, then it will be equally likely outcome. So number of that event or number of possible outcome, when they will be in same in number, then we'll call this is equally likely outcome. So in this video this much. In the next video I'll explain more. Thank you. Take care. God bless you.